Hello, 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 and welcome once again to Movies That Pop. I'm the Colonel. Let's see what popped up in theaters this week. All right, Disney. Is this how it's gonna be now? You're gonna pull a Marvel on the Star Wars universe? We're going to get at least one Star Wars movie each year? Some that advance the story further, and some, like Rogue One, that simply tell a great standalone story from beginning to end? Because, seriously, if you keep them at this level, I will be giving you my money for years, and gladly. Seriously, guys, Disney is going to have all the money, all of it! I think it's astonishing that Disney, the company that, among many other things, is known for their ability to create, protect, and properly exploit classic characters. Or even any Hollywood studio these days, which are all known to attempt to try and make a tentpole out of everything, with reboots and spin-offs forever in perpetuity, that Disney had the nerve to take the biggest tentpole of all time and spend hundreds of millions of dollars to create a movie that features a handful of new, winning characters and that pledges never to use them again. Except in this movie. One shot, this is it. You want sequels? Oh, they got sequels. There's another one coming this time next year, featuring Rey, Finn, Kylo Ren, BB-8, and all those guys. But I simply have to applaud, as most of the sold-out crowd did throughout this rousing war film, and I do mean war film, Rogue One has put the war back in Star Wars. Disney and director Gareth Edwards and writers Chris Weitz and Tony Gilroy have created a war movie featuring characters that we must first be freshly introduced to, but by the film's end, we will never forget. They've created a Dirty Dozen in outer space, an intergalactic heist movie that's lean and focused and looks great, feels completely a part of the Star Wars universe that we all love. I just didn't expect it to be this good. I mean, I thought at best it was gonna be like a feature-length DVD special feature type of thing, a little bonus story to tide you over until the next big sequel. But not only is Rogue One a great movie, not only does it stand on its own, but it has accomplished something that never, never even needed to be done. And if you'd told me that a movie would do it, I'd have told you it was impossible. You know what that is? You know what Rogue One does? It actually makes this movie better! It takes one of the most beloved films of all time and makes it better by retconning one of the film's biggest nitpicks. Oh, and believe me, Star Wars fans love nothing more than nitpicking. They've already found a few odd things to complain about here, mostly having to do with the CGI creation or augmentation of certain familiar characters, and I can tell you it's really mostly okay. It's fine, you get used to it, it's not worth complaining about. Anyway, Rogue One fixes a much maligned plot hole from the first film, but also serves to illustrate just what a snowball's chance that plucky rebellion had in the first place. This story of the mission to steal the Death Star plans that kickstart the story of Luke Skywalker in the original trilogy is so fraught with peril and turmoil and sacrifice that even though you know for a fact that A New Hope begins with the plans in Princess Leia's possession, you get a sense here of just what a absolute miracle that was. It makes the entire journey of the rebellion that much more resonant when you see how this rebellion, which begins in A New Hope and finally succeeds in Return of the Jedi, was very nearly over before it started. This movie makes that very real for you, and you totally buy it. As mentioned, Rogue One follows the team of rebels who steal the plans for the Death Star, but before they can even do that, they must first learn that it even exists, and decide what to do about the fact that it's being built. About an hour into this movie, maybe the slowest portion of it, after you've been introduced to this bounty of rich characters, again, you could sort of argue that you're not introduced to them well enough, the film, which had been intriguing in its setup, really takes a thoughtful turn. You learn pretty early on that not everyone in the rebellion is completely moral and noble. There's bickering and cowardice among the leadership. And there's also some people, like this guy, who are pretty ruthless and cold-blooded. Guys who have no problem with straight-up murder for the right cause. Scoundrels, in other words. Yeah, our team is made up of a criminal, an assassin, a blind Jedi devotee, and his buddy slash muscle, a defecting Imperial pilot, and even an Imperial droid that has been reprogrammed to work for the good guys, but also must have been programmed with a little too much sass, because this guy, K2SO, as voiced by Alan Tudyk, steals the show. He would make that whiny ninny C-3PO his bitch, for sure. There's a lot of these characters you won't be able to get enough of, but K2SO is at the top of that list. There are conflicting loyalties between some of the team members and the rebel leadership as well that set up a thrilling final ride to the finish. Some characters do indeed go rogue for the noblest of causes with the highest of stakes, and they charge forward into certain doom with none of the usual plot armor that comes with being a major character in a tentpole picture. Anyone could die. Lots of people do. And you enter into this film with the full knowledge that there will not be a sequel. And when the characters are as memorable as the ones in Rogue One, the fate of each one is a very, very big deal. I just keep returning to the sense of wonder that this movie even exists. Such a humble idea on paper has been expanded into a full-fledged, self-contained, thrilling action story that is emotionally resonant and designed to sell a massive amount of popcorn. Which, incidentally, is what I award Rogue One, A Star Wars Story, extra large bag of popcorn for this exhilarating experience that does a lot more than simply keep you entertained between episodes. It carries the torch of the Star Wars saga admirably and uses it to illuminate beautiful dimensions to this story that had yet to be discovered. That does it for this edition of Movies That Pop. Don't forget to follow me, the Colonel, on Twitter at Movies That Pop. And click the icon right down there to visit our channel if you'd like to see more, and support us by clicking subscribe while you're there, and by clicking the thumbs up icon below. I'd like to hear your thoughts on Rogue One as well. What was your favorite part? Favorite characters? Blast away in the comments section below, but please, please, keep it spoiler free. I didn't even think it was possible to get spoiled on a movie whose outcome was certain. It was like the thought of being spoiled on Titanic. But a week before this film came out, I learned some things I really wish I hadn't known going in. So let's keep it clean in there, okay? In the meantime, thanks for watching. I'm the Colonel. Stay on target. Stay on target.